Bangkit.
Mitchell has never met anybody who loved them as much as his family. His brother and father played chess almost every night. Mitchell have often watched and sometimes played. But his father and brother were pretty good. Mitchell hardly ever won. When his brother and father was playing, Mitchell moved closer from the board. His father was playing the white pieces, and his brother was playing in the black pieces. And Mitch supported his father, the player, in the white pieces. And then his brother destroyed the kingdom. He angry and crying. He think the kingdom was really light. Who caught you? They were so brave. You've destroyed their kingdom. I hate you. I hate you. You destroyer, said Mitchell. Mitchell, his father did. Can't quite stand for shooting him. It's just a game. Don't take it so badly. No, you don't understand. It destroys everything. Mitchell cried as he ran to his bedroom. Lying on his bed, Mitchell's mind was whirling. He drifted into a dream of battle, soldier, sword, and armor. The next morning, it was out of blue. As he lay in his warm bed, Mitch tried to remember the chess game and the battle. Did I imagine it, or did it really happen? Last night, battle was clear and really and real. Last night, battle was clear and real in his mind. This was great. He just had to remember not to get too upset. Now he won't try another game. Mitchell looked around his room. Then he saw just the thing on top of his wardrobe. It was a battle game, played on a huge battlefield that you spread out in the floor. Yes, 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 he shouted. The game was huge. It had knights, archers, demon magicians, and witches. If you could see into the game, it would be magic. It would be great. He couldn't even think how cool it would be. He cried the game into some room. We featured of being a powerful knight landing his our army into battle. He unfolded the battlefield, picked up the plastic castle at the bottom of the mountain, and then he picked out a group of imperial guards and upset them down in pairs. Grabbing the archer, he put them in kind defensive position. Next, he put down opponent. Of the warfare, jet, big vegetable, and the odds. The job was to guard the Eiffel Castle with its central keep. Mitch and his army were going to defeat the supporters of Eiffel. Everything was in place. All he had to do was grab a weapon. He went back into his bedroom and grabbed his large plastic sword and its matching helmet. Over his pajamas, he buckled his seat and put on his helmet. With a roll on the chest, he started the game. He moved the knife forward, but he couldn't see any movement. He rose again and opened the gestures. The father were still frozen in a passive grimace. We wasn't anything happening. How could he have been so stupid? Kingston come to life. It must have been a dream. Disappointed, he walked onto the plastic battlefield to pick up the castle. As he stepped onto the game, he felt a bolt of electricity run up atop his feet. Everything went dim and icy cold. The sunroom started to pick up and fly apart and fly apart as he started to scream. He landed with a locked-door question in check mode. Something had hit him on the back of the head. He lay sprawled in the mud. Teeth in his mouth and a heavy weight on his back. And then he met with a knight in his dream. The knight was fat, ugly, and frightening. The knight instructed Mitch to go with him. And then a good cutting dragon came from the bushes. And huge suffering was came rushing toward them. The knight had tripped as his horse rushed up and squealed. As it hovers, hit the ground. The knight's sword crashed down onto the covered them, but with shaking, brought horse, and the knight dragged itself up into the saddle. The galloper turned in the mountain toward the castle, moving thundering, and then turned in the valley. The knight mounted and gathered up at the central tower. Mid and the knight were looking to the tower. It is the place of the High King. And there were the orc and the big flesh look that endangered the knight, the High King. But the knight confused. How did they get in? Because they were guarding the only entrance. And then the knight remembered. There was something in the southern corner of the castle. Maybe they find the chapter. And then they go to the castle and meet Kerrigan, the chapter, and come down to the dungeon of the tower. When he entered in the dungeon, he shouted the guy to open the door to help the king. And then the big feather took out and he broke the cave, but missed to beat the tube and started taking the key. And he started to help the king. And then Mitch and the king come out from the tower. Then there was a turn of fighting. That was fighting between the knight and the orc. And then the knight successfully to beat the orc. And finally, the king was severed by them. And then Mitch was getting up from his sleep. And he did not scare. Mitch felt so happy. And then his mother came and walking into the room with a tray of pancakes, juice, and honey. When Mitch had his breakfast, he took upon the game. Would he ever be back? Maybe he could try a different game. He looked around on the room and then his eyes came to rest on the computer. I wondered